Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Arun Singh Thakur from University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management, Punjab University, Chandigarh. Today, we are going to discuss about the module Case Studies related to exploring possibilities of special interest travel in India and in the world from the paper Special Interest Tourism. After completing this module, students, you will be able to understand the concept of special interest tourism. You will be able to understand the current and future developments in the special interest tourism, then understand the scope for special interest travel within India, then understand the scope for special interest travel in the world. Then let us start with the main content of the module. The term special interest tourism used in a variety of ways, both in the academic literature and within the industry. For some, it is synonymous with alternative tourism as opposed to mass tourism. The growth of mass package tourism in the decades after the Second World War appears to be slowing down due to a number of industry and social factors. The mature mass tourist market is tiring of the sun, sea and sand, package holiday and looking for the alternatives, while the emerging new breed of the tourist is less interested in such holidays. A special interest tourist chooses to engage with a product or service that satisfy particular interest and needs. So, the special interest tourism is tourism undertaken for a distinct and specific reason. The distinguishing features of special interest tourism in this sense therefore include the focus on specialist hobbies, interest and activities, the range of which, as we will see, is very diverse, that is from bird watching to military history, golf to opera to bungee jumping. Further, we shall be understanding the concept of special interest tourism. A well-known and widely accepted definition of the tourism is to travel for recreation and leisure purposes. In 1994, the United Nations categorized tourism into three forms with regard to a specific country, that is, inbound tourism, domestic tourism, and the outbound tourism. The first one involves non-residents traveling into this country. The second includes the residents of the same country traveling only within the same country, and the third one involves the residents of a country traveling to a foreign country. By combining these three forms of tourism, the United Nations created three main categories of tourism. The internal tourism, which is an amalgam of both domestic and inbound tourism, national tourism consisting domestic tourism and outbound tourism, and then comes the international tourism, which includes inbound and outbound tourism. The special interest tourists enjoy activities in contrast with the nature, beauty of conserved natural area, the pleasure of watching the fauna in its natural habitat, of exploring, discovering and learning, overcoming the obstacles and feeling the pleasure of overcoming them. Furthermore, they like to discover how easy it is to read a map, navigate a river and learn climbing techniques, diving, horse riding, canoeing, driving, cattle, packing and carrying a rucksack. For that, the tourist, the physical efforts involved is a small price to pay for enjoying the view of a mountain, camping next to the lake of still clear water, or watching an eagle soaring in the wind. All there is the pleasure of sharing experiences with the friends and relatives. Then next, we will discuss the types of special interest tourism. The special interest tourism has rapidly increased in the past few years. Special interest tourists are motivated by the desire to go on a holiday and take part in the current interest or develop a new interest in new or familiar location. The special interest tourism is a niche market similar to adventure tourism, but it differs in that it involves little or no physical exertion. The special interest may be a one-off interest, for example, going on a safari, whitewater rafting, or shark cage diving, or an ongoing interest, for example, the spiritual tourism. Some of the most popular special interest tourism products includes the following. The first in the category is the adventure tourism. Adventure means different things to different people, but common themes in the adventure tourism include the elements such as real or perceived, risk, excitement, uncertainty, and challenge. Physical pursuits may therefore be more risky, extreme, or unusual than the activity or the sporting tours like sea kayaking, whitewater rafting, rock climbing or canoeing, bungee jumping, and so on. The element of adventure may not be directly physical, but may come from travel to exotic or different destinations, contact with relatively undeveloped nature or other cultures, or using unusual and challenging modes of transportation. For example, the four-wheel drives or the mountain bikes. The next is the agritourism, also called as the farm tourism or agrotourism. Agritourism or agrotourism, as it is defined most broadly, involves any agriculturally based operation or activity that brings visitor to a farm or fields. This involves activities such as the fruit picking. They may visit factories that process farm produce, for example, the jams and pickles, and may stay overnight in the farmhouse for bed and breakfast. Then, ancestry tourism. Tourists travel to the destination with the aim of learning more about and possibility tracing their ancestors. Next is the aviotourism or bird watching. The bird watching is one of the popular hobbies all over the world. Bird watching tours are conducted in the areas known to be rich in bird life or the rare species. Visit to the national parks, wetlands, or the wildlife refuges, guiding bird walks or hikes. Southern Africa is one of the richest birding regions with a vast networking of bird routes. The next type of tourism is the battlefield tourism. Tours to battlefields of the past or active zones for recreation purpose or study have grown in the popularity. Greece, Italy, Turkey, and Iran have become popular battlefield destinations. Then comes the birth tourism. Birth tourism refers to a travel to another country or a place for the purpose of giving birth to a child in that country. The main reason behind the birth tourism is to obtain citizenship for the child in a country with birthright citizenship. The popular destinations for birth tourism include Canada, Australia, France, Germany, Hong Kong, and the United States of America. To discourage birth tourism, Australia, many countries have modified their laws of citizenship, wherein citizenship by birth is granted only if at least one parent is a citizen or a legal permanent resident of the country. Next type is the culinary tourism or the food tourism. Foodies or the food lovers throng to a destination in order to experience cuisine and food festivals. Culinary tourism refers to the travel that has food as the primary motivating factor or influence in their travel behavior and in their decision-making process. The another one is the cruise tourism. Cruise tourism is a form of luxurious traveling which involves an all-inclusive holiday on a cruise ship for at least 48 hours as per the specific itinerary, in which the cruise ship embarks at the several ports of the cities. As a niche market product, small ship cruising can very well satisfy the tourist seeking soft adventure, cruising, comfort and culture. The next is the dark tourism. Dark tourism, which is also known as the black tourism, has been defined as tourism involving travel to places which are historically associated with death and tragedy. The main attraction linked to dark location is their historical value rather than their being associated with death or suffering. The another type is the ethnic tourism. Ethnic tourism, which focuses on encountering and learning about the traditional, unwesternized, distinctive and at times vanishing cultures of ethnic or indigenous people groups. This may also be referred as indigenous tourism, wherein the indigenous people themselves are primarily involved in providing services and managing the tourism products. Then another famous type is the ecotourism, or be the wildlife tourism. As per International Ecotourism Society, ecotourism is defined as the responsible travel to the natural areas that conserves the environment, sustains the well-being of the local people, and involves interpretation and education. Ecotourism should provide the direct financial benefits for the conservation and local people, and its focus is on the conservation of the natural resources. Then comes the gambling tourism. Gambling tourism caters to the tourist who visit casinos, destinations and holiday in gambling cities that have many casinos as a part of their tourism products. Then next is the genealogy tourism. Genealogy tourism is defined as the journey of discovery. It is a journey of discovery that isn't over until you have actually visited your ancestral homeland. Genealogy is by definition the process by which basic information about the births, marriages and deaths is linked together in form of a family tree. Then comes the heritage tourism. Recent tourism trends have been characterized by an increased interest in the natural and cultural heritage, which is also termed as a tangible and intangible heritage. Tradition and culture based tourism engages those tourists who have the desire to learn, to experience, to discover and to be the part of the host community and the environment. This form of tourism stimulates a range of activities, certainly beneficial for the local economy of the destination. However, due to the close contact between the visiting and the host community, this may often produce loss of authenticity and commoditization of the resources. The next came the lighthouse tourism. Lighthouse tourism is a niche form of tourism wherein tourists visit and sometimes stay in the lighthouses that provide accommodation for the tourist. The another one is the photographic tourism. While acknowledging the fact that photography is an element of most holidays, the companies specializing in photography tours differentiate themselves by emphasizing the specific features of the trip, such as the opportunity to engage in the act of photography. the photography subjects, personal tuition or workshops, and the provision of services unique to the holiday, such as the inclusion of professional nature photographers as team leaders or as resident experts accompanying the tour. Although the sharing of expertise and the tuition from professionals is a key aspect of many tours, it does mean that a relatively small number of people can be accommodated at any one time. Then comes the property tourism. Tourists travel to the holiday destinations to find and purchase residential property. The property tourism operator who organizes the tour may reimburse all or a portion of the cost of the holiday package that was charged from the tourist if the tourist purchases the property. Then next is the rural tourism, or it can be the cultural tourism. Thus, this type of tourism includes the homestays so that tourists can experience the rural life and food. Rural tourism focuses on the experience of nature which has been shaped by human development. Rural or countryside areas which may be used for agriculture or forestry and which contain the low density settlements such as the villages and farms. The attractions of such areas may be both natural, that includes the scenery, the natural features, and cultural, that may be an interest in the rural traditions, activities, and the way of life. The rural tourism includes a variety of activities such as farm or spa stays, outdoor pursuits, scenic touring, camping, buying produce from the farm stalls, and so on. Then comes the safari tourism. The word safari is derived from the word Swahili for journey, and in colonial times the meaning was that big game would be hunted, shot, and then diligently dragged overland by a small army of local tribal people. Safari now refers to an adventure tour or expedition into the wilds with no hunting involved. Safari travel also provides revenue for the local conservation projects and the game parks, supporting the protection of the wildlife and the habitats rather than taking them out. Then comes the sex tourism. Sex tourism is travel to engage in a sexual activity, particularly with the prostitutes. The World Tourism Organization, a specialized agency of the United Nations, defines sex tourism as the trips organized from within the tourism sector or from outside this sector, but using its structures and networks with the primary purpose of effecting a commercial sexual relationship between the tourist with the residents at the destinations. Then comes the spa tourism. The tourists visit mineral or the hot springs. This type of niche tourism is not bound to any season. This is a year-round activity. The next is the sports tourism. It has been noted that under the broad spectrum of the sport tourism, many sub-segments or the niche markets exist, which includes event sport tourism and active sport tourism. However, it also includes the more distinctive purpose for travel, including sports tour, which includes the traveling as an individual or team to take part in the competition or the tournaments, or the sports spectating, that is the attendance at the sporting event as a spectator, and sports heritage, that is visiting the sites, venues, museums associated with the sports or the famous sporting figures. Major sporting events such as the Olympic Games, Wimbledon tennis, or FIFA World Cup soccer attract the visitors all over the world. Then another one is the space tourism. Space as holiday destination represents a remarkable form of space-time compression with respect to transport and mobility. It has only been 100 years since a human first learned to fly. Not 70 years later, a program for walking on the moon was already in place. Perhaps space tourism in 100 years will be commonplace. Then another one is the tribal tourism. Tribal tourism is a form of niche tourism under which the tourists visit the tribal areas to meet the indigenous people and witness the culture and traditions which are ethnic and distinctive from their own. Then comes the volunteer tourism. Volunteer tourism has its roots in the volunteerism, which implies that individuals offer their services to change some aspect of society for the better. In other words, to participate in the goodwill activities. Whilst the concept of volunteering has a long and established history, the niche of the volunteer tourism is relatively new. The generic term volunteer tourism applies to those tourists who, for various reasons, volunteer in an organized way to undertake the holidays that might involve aiding or alleviating the material poverty of some groups in society, the restoration of the certain environments, or the research into the aspects of the society or environment. The next one is the wedding tourism. This involves honeymooners and the couples wishing to have their wedding ceremonies solemnized at a particular tourist destination. Wedding tourists tend to travel in the quite large number, and the site is termed as the theme destination. Then comes the wellness or spiritual tourism. The wellness tourism is a form of niche travel for the purpose of promoting health and well-being through physical or psychological or spiritual activities. Tourists come to a destination in order to unwind and enjoy reflexology, massages, and meditation. The next one is the wildlife tourism. Tourists participate in the activities such as safaris, viewing marine wildlife, and photographing the wildlife. Wildlife tourism is focused on the observation of the wild animals and birds. It embraces a wide range of activities such as the wildlife themed holiday packages, for example, safaris, visit to the natural reserves, zoos, and safari parks, whale or dolphin watching cruises. This would often overlap with the adventure tourism. Then comes the wine tourism. Tourists visit the wine growing regions and the wine routes, vineyards, wineries, and the wine festivals, so on and so forth, for the purpose of consuming or purchasing the wine. Wine tourism is a subset of food tourism, being defined as the visitations to vineyards, wineries, wine festivals, wine shows, for which the grape wine tasting or experiencing the attributes of the grape wine region are the prime motivation factors for the visitor. Now, we will discuss the special interest travel destinations in India. For the adventure activity type of tourism, the various destinations are Himachal, Uttarakhand, Goa, and Ladakh, which are popular, and the tourist can involve in the activities like heli skiing, skydiving, hot air ballooning, trekking, rappelling, snorkeling, scuba diving, etc. Then for the agri tourism, the destinations like Nasik, Pune, they are famous, and the activities can be done: the farm tour, tractor trolley ride, bullock cart ride, forest walk, cultural activity, etc. For the heavy tourism, the destinations of Jim Corbett National Park, the Bharatpur Fort, and Keoladu National Park, the Pangot, Bhigwan, they are the famous one, and the activities can be the word watching, museum visit and camping. Then comes the culinary tourism. The famous destination in India are the Delhi, Jaipur, Agra, Varanasi, Udaipur, Jodhpur and Mumbai. And the activities the person can involve in the food walks, food tasting, cookery classes, culinary competitions, etc. For ecotourism can be done in Periyar National Park, Kaziranga National Parks and in many other places, and the activities can be backpacking, safaris, jungle walks, etc. For the heritage tourism, although there are many places, but the Taj Mahal, Lotus Temple, Humayun's Tomb, Red Fort are the few which are famous. For the rural tourism, run of Kutch, Spiti, Amritsar, Ladakh and many rural areas of India are the famous one. And the various activities can be the homestays, local food, walking tours and the rural sports, etc. Then for the voluntourism, the Kanda, Spiti, Jaipur, Goa, they are the famous, and the tourist can involve in the work like orphanage work and the women empowerment and the rural empowerment in those areas. For the wildlife tourism, the Corbett National Park, Ranthambore National Park, Sariska Wildlife Sanctuaries, Bandhavgarh National Parks and many wildlife sanctuaries and other national parks of the India, they are the famous. And for the wine tourism, the Nasik and Nandi Hills, Akluj and Dhindori are the famous one. Further, we will discuss the special interest tourism sites in the world and the activities. For the adventure, the famous countries are the New Zealand, USA, Australia and South Africa. And the activities are the skydiving, zip lining, bridge climbing, bungee jumping, rafting, sandboarding, rock climbing, etc. For the agritourism, the countries they are famous are Taiwan, Brazil, Hawaii. For the avitourism, New Guyana, Kruger National Park, South Africa, Rift Valley in Kenya, New Zealand, Queensland, Australia, Ecuador are few countries which are famous with the activities of word watching, camping, hiking. Then for the culinary tourism, the famous countries are the Australia, China, France, India, Italy, Japan, Mexico, Thailand and USA. And the food walks, food tasting, cookeries, classes and the culinary competition are the few activities they can be done. Then comes for the ecotourism, Kenya, Norway, Antarctica, Iceland, Amazon rainforest are the famous destination. For the heritage tourism, it's Great Barrier Reef in Australia, the Petra Jordan, St. Petersburgs, and many more in the rest part of the world. Then for the rural tourism, Cambodia, Costa Rica, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, and India are the best places. For the voluntourism, Ethiopia, Ghana, Kenya, Myanmar, Vietnam, and even the India is the popular stations. Then for the wildlife tourism, Tanzania, Australia, Mexico, Namibia, they are the famous destinations. Then for the wine tourism, it's Italy, New Zealand and South Africa are few countries which are the famous. Now let us summarize what we have learned in this module. The special interest tourism can be defined as the provision of customized leisure and recreational experiences driven by the specific expressed interest of individuals and or the groups. The special interest tourists are seeking more authentic experiences that enable the closer interaction with the host community in a non-exploitative manner along with the more personalized service. As a tourist, we want to travel to exotic, wild and beautiful places, but are outraged by the number of impacts of the large number of fellow human beings doing likewise. Tourism is growing at a faster rate than other industries. This trend is likely to continue, but the challenge is for the growth to be managed in a sustainable way. In reality, it is difficult as we are threatening the very places we admire, the coastlines, the rainforest, and the vast wilderness. Although special interest tourism encourages travel to the places like Antarctica or into the villages in remote places, it brings with it a social and ecological impacts of the human activity, development and modernity. A consequence of the growing popularity of the special interest tourism and of initially the small number of alternative tourists exploring previously visited places, whether they be remote or the urban, in developing or the developed nations, is ultimately to open these spaces for the mass tourism. The alternate tourist will then seek to penetrate even deeper into unspoiled places. The special interest tourist is often small scale and the locally based. It can be related to the local character through rural tourism, to the people through indigenous tourism, to the heritage tourism, and to the natural environment through the eco-tourism. Agro-tourism, which is a part of the rural and the cultural tourism, may face the similar dilemma while developing, though it is still in the nascent stage. Looking at the pace at which the tourism is developing, it thought has to be given to the sustainable development aspect to avoid the negative impacts of tourism. Thank you.